It's time for the Todd Wilkerson Show. Join us each week as we talk Heritage Hills Patriots football. Search our Roku channel by searching SW Indiana Sports Network or on our website at SWIndianaSportsNetwork.com. Go Patriots!
Hey everyone, Joey Chestnut here, world champion competitive eater. I follow Southwest Indiana Sports Network, and if you're hungry for sports, you should follow them too.
Follow the Southwest Indiana Sports Network at SWISportsNetwork.com or search Roku for our channel at SW Indiana Sports Network.
Wanting to scan those old videos, films, or audio to DVD? We'll look no further than Milligan Communications. We can also scan your old pictures, slides, and negatives to picture quality as well. With thousands of happy customers, let Milligan Communications help put your treasured memories on a digital media. Call Milligan Communications today at 812-630-2449. Milligan Communications, capturing your yesterdays.
It's time for this week's Buzzer Beaters. Listen as our experts pick the results of five local games. Buzzer Beaters, every week exclusively on the Southwestern Indiana Sports Network.
Welcome to this week's Todd Wilkerson Show. Coach, last week you had the Battle of Spencer County where you took on South Spencer, down South Spencer. Why don't you recap that game for us?
Yeah, Joe, we came out and played really well. I was very pleased with our team. We were very concerned about containing Ty Brown, South Spencer's dynamic quarterback, so we really worked hard all week on a good defensive game plan, I thought, and the defense just played outstanding. South Spencer had trouble getting anything going in the first half, and we executed very well offensively. Jet ran the ball well. He had 7 rushes for 100 yards and 2 touchdowns. Braden Durham had 6 rushes for 46 yards and a touchdown. We got some other guys involved in the passing game, which was nice. Jet was 7 for 9, passing for 132 yards, which is a really nice compliment to our run game. We had Caleb Schmidt catch a touchdown pass. Tyler Ruxer got a touchdown run. Meredith caught a touchdown pass. So got a lot of guys involved and really diversified our offense, I felt like. Switched things up quite a bit and had really good execution. So along with really good defensive play, we just came out and had a great first half there and got up big. I think it was 40-0 at halftime, and then got to put the young kids in the second half and let them play. And so just a really great effort. Sometimes you come into a week where you people are telling you you're heavily favored or you're favored, and kids don't come in with the right mental approach. And I was very pleased with the way we came out and played because we played to a very high level. So just an outstanding effort.
And Durham and Goldsberry and Meredith get a lot of the press, but when you have 4 people or 3 people averaging scoring over at least 4 touchdowns a game, you got to attribute some of that to the offensive line too.
Yeah, you know, I feel like we've got some, you know, we've definitely got some guys who can put the ball in the end zone with their legs, but it's so nice to see, you know, again, Caleb Schmidt catching a nice long touchdown pass, and then Tyler Ruxer had a nice touchdown run on a jet sweep, and just knowing we've got more weapons, and you know, we've got Preston Coop, who's probably one of our best receivers at H-back, that the way things have worked, we just haven't got him real involved yet at this point. He does a tremendous job blocking and catches the ball really well, but just because of the way the games have played out so far this year, you know, several other guys have been the ones catching the balls or getting the run. So we feel like we've got quite a few weapons there. And then again, like I said, the defense just played outstanding, and we just need to continue to play that way.
And, you know, I was talking about your three running backs and your offensive line, and, you know, you got to love that you're averaging 9.1 yards per carry.
Yeah, it definitely takes the heat off everything when we're running the ball well. I think we're definitely going to be tested these next few weeks as we play some top tier teams here with North Posey coming up, Gibson Southern, behind them. So we're going to really find out how good we are in the run game. But you're right, it gets us in short yardage situations on second and third down, and you know, it just we've been pretty explosive to this point too, ripping off some big runs. So pleased with the way things are going, but you know, again, it's week four. We're going into week five here. We feel like there's a lot of season ahead, and we've got to continue to get better. But very happy with that offensive line. You know, I talked about them in the preseason again about how they really needed to be a part of our identity, and they've done a great job doing that. And very pleased. We just got to keep cleaning up details and keep getting better every week.
And you're listening to the Todd Wilkerson Show on South Carolina Sports Network, powered by Million Bros for Communications. We'll be back right after these messages for our sponsors.
When you think sporting goods, think no further than All-Star Sports in Ferdinand. Custom embroidery, screen printing, team uniforms, sports equipment, and sports apparel and shoes. We have it all. Give Brad a call today at 812-367-1618. Or visit them in the Country Plaza Shopping Center in Ferdinand. All-Star Sports is open Monday through Friday, 10 to 7, and Saturday, 9 to 4. All-Star Sports, when you're thinking sporting goods.
Life's better under our roof. That's because our expert agents will make you feel totally protected with the right auto and home coverage at the right price. Also, you can enjoy the dreams you worked so hard to achieve. American Family Insurance. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Hooray for Mr. Touchdown. He's gonna beat him today. So If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Life's better under our roof. That's because our expert agents will make you feel totally protected with the right auto and home coverage at the right price. Also, you can enjoy the dreams you've worked so hard to achieve. American Family Insurance. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
It's time for this week's Buzzer Beaters. Listen as our experts pick the results of five local games. Buzzer Beaters, every week exclusively on the Southwestern Indiana Sports Network.
Welcome to this week's Todd Wilkerson Show. Coach, last week you had the Battle of Spencer County where you took on South Spencer, down South Spencer. Why don't you recap that game for us?
Yeah, Joe, we came out and played really well. I was very pleased with our team. We were very concerned about containing Ty Brown, South Spencer's dynamic quarterback, so we really worked hard all week. A good defensive game plan, I thought, and the defense just played outstanding. South Spencer had trouble getting anything going in the first half, and we executed very well offensively. Jet ran the ball well. He had 7 rushes for 100 yards and 2 touchdowns. Braden Durham had 6 rushes for 46 yards and a touchdown. We got some other guys involved in the passing game, which was nice. Jet was 7 for 9, passing for 132 yards, which is a really nice complement to our run game. We had Caleb Schmidt catch a touchdown pass. Tyler Ruxer got a touchdown run. Meredith caught a touchdown pass. So got a lot of guys involved and really diversified our offense, I felt like. Switched things up quite a bit and had really good execution. So along with really good defensive play, we just came out and had a great first half there and got up big. I think it was 40-0 at halftime, and then got to put the young kids in the second half and let them play. And so just a really great effort. You know, sometimes you come into a week where you people are telling you're heavily favored or you're favored, and kids don't come in with the right mental approach. And I was very pleased with the way we came out and played because we played to a very high level. So just an outstanding effort.
And you know, Durham and Goldsberry and Meredith get a lot of the press, but you know, when you have 4 people or 3 people averaging scoring over at least 4 touchdowns a game, you got to attribute some of that to the offensive line too.
Yeah, I feel like we've got some, we've definitely got some guys who can put the ball in the end zone with their legs, but it's so nice to see, again, Caleb Schmidt catching a nice long touchdown pass, and then Tyler Ruxer had a nice touchdown run on a jet sweep, and just knowing we've got more weapons, and we've got Preston Coop, who's probably one of our best receivers at H-back, that the way things have worked, we just haven't got him real involved yet at this point. He does a tremendous job blocking and catches the ball really well, but just because of the way the games have played out so far this year, several other guys have been the ones catching the balls or getting the run. So we feel like we've got quite a few weapons there. And then again, like I said, the defense just played outstanding, and we just need to continue to play that way.
And, I was talking about your 3 running backs and your offensive line, and you got to love that you're averaging 9.1 yards per carry.
Yeah, it definitely takes the heat off everything when we're running the ball well. I think we're definitely going to be tested these next few weeks as we play some top tier teams here with North Posey coming up, Gibson Southern, behind them. So we're going to really find out how good we are in the run game. But you're right, it gets us in short yardage situations on second and third down, and it just we've been pretty explosive to this point too, ripping off some big runs. So pleased with the way things are going, but again, it's week 4. We've going into week 5 here. We feel like there's a lot of season ahead, and we've got to continue to get better. But very happy with that offensive line. I talked about them in the preseason again about how they really needed to be a part of our identity, and they've done a great job doing that, and very pleased. We just got to keep cleaning up details and keep getting better every week.
And you're listening to the Todd Wilkerson Show on South Park, powered by Million Grossberg Communications. Back to the message from sponsors.
It's time for the Todd Wilkerson Show. Join us each week as we talk Heritage Hills Patriots football. Search our Roku channel by searching SW Indiana Sports Network or on our website at SWIndianaSportsNetwork.com. Go Patriots!